The new Master Duel meta is here. Because of the set Spright of Miracles, we are going to be seeing some crazy new strategies, and it is going to be insane. One thing I have to say for our TCG players that play Master Duel is that it's going to be a completely different ball game than what we were used to in the TCG, as this is an entirely different monster. We're going to see Joshan versus Hero Beat, and it looks like Joshan is playing the Spright strategy. For the people that don't know what Spright strategies are, what the Spright strategy is, it is a series of level 2 thunder monsters that can summon themselves to the side of the field by controlling a level 2 monster. Meaning that this deck really works well with any deck that has a ton of level 2 monsters and can work through them. It can also link and exceed summon into rank and level 2 link 2 monsters respectively, but most of the time you're locked into only being able to summon link rank 2 monsters to your side of the field. Joshan in this particular hand has Swap Frog, Nimble Beaver, Ash Blossom, Arch Nemesis Protos, and a Triple Tactics talent, and this is a diamond raid match, so I expect nothing but phenomenal gameplay here. Hero Beat starts off with Live Twin Sunny Snitch. He's going to get Live Twin Kisa Kill from his deck to his hand. I haven't seen this strategy in a while. Kisa Kill then special summons Leela from the deck. Oh, okay. Like I said, this strategy is really good at being able to mix well with any deck that focuses on twos. And this Live Twin Sprite is a variant that you're going to see a lot. Sprite Blue, when summoned, allows him to add a Sprite Monster from his deck to his hand. He'll add Sprite Carrot. And now he'll exceed summon with both Sprite Carrot or with his Live Twin Monsters into Gigantic Sprite. Now, this card's actually ridiculous. It allows you to detach one material, special summon one level 2 monster from his deck, and then also, neither player can special summon level 2, link 2, or rank 2 monsters higher than level 2, link 2, and rank 2 monsters for the rest of the turn. So, if he resolves the effect of Gigantic Sprite, Nibiru the Primal Being cannot be used. Your opponent cannot Nibiru you if you resolve Sprite. But what's really interesting is that he didn't decide to protect his Gigantic Sprite with a monster named Sprite Red. So I'm thinking that his Gigantic Sprite just might be bait. We'll go ahead and Ash Blossom and Joy Screen the Gigantic Sprite. Since his effect was negated, none of us are locked. He'll special summon Sprite Jet, allowing him to add a spell or trap card from his deck to his hand. That's Sprite Starter. And now he's going to link off with his Gigantic Sprite and his Sprite Jet. Oh my god, this is crazy. He's going to make Artifact Dagda, huh? He'll special summon Sprite Carrot. Activate Sprite Starter. Trigger the effect of Artifact Dagda. That allows him to set an Artifact Monster to a Spell and Trap Card Zone. He's going to set the Artifact Scythe. Sprite Starter is going to special summon Red. And now it looks like he's going to show his true intentions. He's going to link the blue and the Dagda off into a Sprite Elf. Sprite Elf will special summon a Live Twin Leela or Kisa Kill to the side of the field. What is he going to make here? He's going to make IP Masquerina. So, okay, IP can link into an opponent's... Huh? Hero! What in the actual? Hold on. Did he just summon two monsters, link them off for an IP Masquerina, then link those off for a Kisa Kill? It feels like he's doing this backwards, but there has to be a method to his madness. This man is in Diamond 1 for a reason. Kisa Kill will activate its effect to being able to special summon Sprite Blue. And now we'll use Sprite Blue and the Leela for another link summon into Evil Twin Leela. Okay. Leela will then special summon his Kisa Kill. He's locked into Fiend Monsters as well now. Kisa Kill will get him a draw. And now he's going to link summon back into an Evil Twin Kisa Kill set one pass. So the Sprite Live Twin strategy is really cool because you get some really insane extenders for the deck, for the Live Twin deck. And since the Live Twin strategy doesn't require a lot to be able to play effectively, those strategies both mesh in harmony. In this particular situation, he has Evil Twin Kisa Kill that can special summon the Evil Twin Leela to the side of the field, which will destroy his Artifact Scythe, preventing Joshan from being able to play Yu-Gi-Oh! So that is ridiculous. He also has Sprite Elf, which now is starting to make sense. He can use Sprite Elf to special summon his IP Masquerina and then link summon. So he has quite a few disruptions here. Also, the opponent takes 200 damage every time a monster is normal summon or special summon, and you gained 200 life points. So really, really cool. Joshan's going to go ahead and start off his turn. This is pretty good hand. Oh, no. Not the Maxine for the sixth card, my brother in Christ. Oh, no. That's unlucky. He'll then normal summon Swap Frog. We'll activate the Swap Frog effect. He'll chain the Kisa Kill here. This is the first time he could use it. We'll use Maxi in response. He'll activate Spright Elf in response. Oh, that's actually really smart. We won't be able to draw from the Spright Elf special summon since it was chained to the Maxi. But we will draw from the Live Twin Leela summon. And we'll send Ronin to the graveyard. Leela will then destroy our artifact sites, and then we'll chain IP Masquerado. Kind of cocky, aren't we? Why now? We're going to link IP and the Kisa Kill. We're going to turn it into a Nightmare Griffin. Oh my god. We'll destroy the artifact site, trigger the effect of sites, and Nightmare Griffin. We're going to be able to use Nightmare Griffin to set, and then Live Twin Leela to be able to special summon. Oh my god, guys. Lots of gameplay going on here. We'll special summon the Leela. He'll draw a card. Nightmare Griffin will draw because it's co-linked and set a card. We'll special summon Artifact Scythe, draw another card, and Scythe will prevent us from special summoning from the extra deck. Kisa Kill will get him a draw. That was a complete mouthful. It was a mouthful. It was like, what is going on? We summoned more times on his turn than it felt like our turn. Let's assess this board. Nightmare Griffin prevents any monster from activating its effect that's special summoned unless it's linked. We're able to activate the effect of Artifact Scythe because link means as long as an arrow points to your monster, co-linked means two arrows must point to each other. So we're able to activate the scythe here. We also have Leela draw, and when one of these cards goes to the graveyard, the other one can come back. We have game if Joshan can't do anything about this. So let's see what he does. We can also special summon from the extra deck too. We're gonna use Triple Tactics Talent. We're gonna take the Nightmare Griffin, meaning that we can activate our effects. We'll return the Swap Frog and then summon it again. Using the effect of Swap Frog, he will Ash Blossom and Joyous Spring. My guy, kinda cocky now, huh? We still got five cards in hand. I mean, to be honest, I'm not sure if I would've stopped the Swap Frog. I would assume with additional five other cards in his hand, he's going to be able to link summon or summon more twos to his side of the field. And he already can't summon, so what's the point of stopping the Swap Frog with an Ash Blossom? I'm not sure, though. We'll gain some more and inflict some more. Battle Phase will attack over his Live Twin monsters. This is really smart by him. Now we'll go ahead and banish three for Arcanimus's Protos. This card's really dirty. We're going to declare one monster type, destroy all monsters in the field with that type, and it can't be summoned for the next turn. We declare Thunder. So he has Infinite Impermanence, definitely. Because Hero was not going to be playing any games. Oh, crazy. We'll then summon Nemesis Flag by returning the Maxi. Flag's other effect will go ahead and add us an Arcanimus's Protos. Doggy even wants to see. And then we'll activate the effect of our Arcanimus's Protos. Crazy. Saber wants to see the game, guys. Saber wants to see the game. She's literally looking at the game. I wish you guys could see her. But Arcanimus's Protos, what did we declare? Because Saber got in my way. Fire was selected. That is crazy. So it seems like from here that fire monsters like Sprite Elf can't be summoned. Sprite Red can't be summoned. And Escatos was negated, so we won't be able to use the, or we still can summon Thunder Monsters. Hero Pete's not in a terrible situation, but we know that this is a phase down Sprite starter, and we purposely put an Infinite Impermanence in said spot. So let's see how Hero Beat will come back to this game. Saber heard Sprite, and she's all up into it. We're going to activate another Sunny Snitch going out at our Kisa Kill. Kisa Kill won't be able to summon from the deck because it's not our only monster. And we'll infirm the Kisa Kill anyways. That's actually to get rid of the Sprite starter here. So we'll go ahead and special summon Sprite Blue to our side of the field. Sprite Blue adds Sprite Jet. We'll then special summon Sprite Jet. Sprite Jet adds Sprite Smasher. So it looks like Hero Beat has the opportunity to break this board. Stop, Saber! Watch the game! We'll then XE summon into Gigantic Sprite. Using the effect of Gigantic Sprite, we'll special summon a Live Twin Leela. You like the cat shark at least? Stop it. Cat shark will then double the attack of gigantic sprite, and then we'll attack over the arch nemesis Descatos. We'll attack over the smoke bomb, and then we'll activate sprite smashers, banishing the sprite starter. Oh God, Saber, Kittle. Holy God, Saber, you're too much. Kittle. We'll banish the cat shark off the field to be able to get rid of the arch nemesis Protos. This is probably one of the most insane videos I put out here. We were able to break the board. Hero beat completely taking back control of this game. We're going to need to get into this game somehow. But fortunately enough, Hero beat only has one card left in hand. Doesn't seem to be the best card in the world. Gigantic Sprite and Artifact Scythe. So not necessarily a very strong board. All we need is pretty much a starter and we're back in this game. We draw a Sprite Blue to get the combo off. Normal summon Hyperia, get our Sprite starter, and he is going to scoop. Come here, girl. I gotta give this a 5 out of 5 Squamata game. Saber likes it. Saber likes the game. Right. Saber likes the game. She's such a good girl. But let me know, what do you guys think? And if you have any games that is from the Spider Miracles, involving the Spider Miracles, go ahead and post down below following the rules in the description. I hope you guys are having an amazing day, and I'll catch you on the next one. Happy Valentine's Day, everybody.